answer. And I'm a member of parliament from Zambia. The Zambian parliament actually represents a constituency in Changa constituency in the Copperbelt part, which is a predominantly mining constituency. I'm very happy to be here. This is the CPA meeting on extractive industries, which has been run with the World Bank, in conjunction with the World Bank, running from the 7th to the 11th. And so far, I must say I've gained a lot of tools, I've put them, and shared experiences with other members of parliament from the Commonwealth and from the presenters. Very good presentations. And when I came here, obviously, I came with a view to learn, share experiences, and see what I can pick and take back home to Zambia, to my parliament, and to my country, to my government. And what I can briefly say that I've learned, very importantly, is that in terms of extractive industries, it's very important that whatever infrastructure and framework is in place, it is such that the country, there should be a delicate balance between getting the benefit to the country. From the outset, what I learned very important was, because there's this question all the time as to whether, as a country like Zambia, where we have a lot of natural resources, whether we're getting adequate benefit from the natural resources to the people. And the first thing I learned, that it's very important for countries that have natural resources to ensure that the mechanisms are in place, the legislations in place, to ensure that the resources, as they are removed from the ground, benefit the people, and at the same time benefit the investor. So there's that delicate balance. And also, obviously, with that, to see how we can also equitably distribute that resource to the people to really benefit. And on top of that, I did learn that, look, it's important to know how to use the revenue from resources to reduce poverty and make sure the country develops. Because we find that at times, as government, as countries with resources, we don't make use of that revenue from the resources in the right way to reduce the poverty and to bring development and invest in infrastructure, and what conditions prevail to invest correctly, whether to spend, to invest, or to do elsewhere. So with this put together, there's some total I can say is I've learned very, very much, which I'll take home, the best way to handle revenue from our resources so that it is to the benefit of the country, the people, and to the investors, and there's a win-win. And I must say, I'm learning quite a lot, and there's still more to pick up.
My name is Honorable Professor Ellen Sambili, Member of Parliament from Kenya, the Kenyan National Assembly. I'm one of the 16 re-elected women in the current parliament, and I'm also a member of the Executive CPA, Commonwealth Parliamentary Association Committee in my parliament, and I've come here to attend the conference on extractive industries, and I'm very happy to be here. It's been very interesting. It's my first time to be in a Commonwealth conference. It has been very interesting learning about the policies of extractive industries. Kenya, I've learned a lot about the ways of managing the resources or revenue that comes from extractive industries. Kenya has recently been identified as one of the countries that has oil, and we have the company, the Talo company, that is a British company that has explored and found in Turkana that we have a potential of 6,000 barrels of oil, or 6 million. And it is, when it is explored, it can make Kenya self-sufficient in about 3 to 5 years. And I'm really happy to have been here to learn from other countries, the experiences that have been shared by the experts, the resource people, and the honorable members from other Commonwealth countries. And I believe that I've enjoyed the program. I like the management of the program, the management of time. I go home with a lot of information. I feel, for example, that it is important to be able to protect policies that are dealing with things like extractive industries or resources, so that there can be continuity. And this, these are some of the things that I'll discuss with my colleagues when I go back to Parliament.
My name is Ken Vowles. I represent the Northern Territory Legislative Assembly in Australia. I'm very honoured to be here. It was a conference that I was very keen to attend, simply around extractive industries. We are very rich in resources in the Northern Territory, and there's a lot of revenue raised, and coming to this conference already over the last 3 days has really given me an insight to how to spend that revenue, how to focus on the long-term effects of that revenue, and also how to utilise for the future benefit of our children as well for long-term. It's been an excellent program. We've had excellent speakers from everywhere.
My name is Shamsul Iskandar Muhammad Akhil, and I'm a Member of Parliament, Federal Parliament from constituency of Bukit Katil, Malaysia, where my constituency is located at the southern part of the peninsula of Malaysia. Well, I'm very much excited to participate in the CPA program, in particular this seminar, which I think is very timely, because earlier this year we have made a call to the Prime Minister Najib Razak for Malaysia to have a reference on ET, or Extractive Industry Transparency Initiative, where Malaysia is very much about all revenue. We have been in this industry for the past 30 years, so the younger generation feels that, especially among the MPs in the Parliament, we think that in the years to come there must be an initiative from the federal government to have a proper transparency check and balance to the oil revenues, because all this while we have legislation that only the Prime Minister has the power to check on the national oil industry. So I think these are the common or interesting lessons that we can learn from this seminar. In fact, now we are a ruling party in one of the states where we have sand mining, we have a lot of other revenues that can generate from mining industry. So we are hoping that by lessons from this seminar, we can convince and push to the State Assembly so that proper transparency initiative, a kind of ET, to be introduced in our state government. Thank you.
Well, I return to Quebec and to exchange with my colleagues and to make sure that I'm really impressed of the work that we had done in the last 3 days. And I should explain how we had worked on these sessions, and also encourage my government to pursue in this type of event and make sure that CPA is going to be renewed relationship with Quebec. Thank you.
I have learned that first principle is transparency, and there are so many things we have learned here. When I will go back to my country, Pakistan, I'll share my experiences to my colleagues and the other members of National Assembly, so that they also approve their thinking and they also be more beneficiary to the Parliament.
I am Honourable Lisinga Arthur Keke from Cameroon, a Member of Parliament in the National House of Assembly, and I sit on the Production and Trade Committee of the House of Assembly. And we oversee activities of the extractive industries in our country. This seminar has been quite educative and instructive. I've met people from diverse horizons, very experienced professionals, and members of parliament with a wealth of experience. And I think that sharing this experience during the seminar will help me contribute a lot in shaping up our extractive industries in our country.
Hello, my name is Andrew Mitchell. I'm from the Parliament of Western Australia. I'm at the Extractive Industries conference run by the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association, because Western Australia has a major industry with the extractive industries, and it's very important for us to get a broader perspective on how other countries operate and also how we operate within and how we could operate. So it's very important that I expand my horizons, that I get a greater understanding, and so far this conference has achieved that. Take back to my parliament is a greater understanding of the economics. I've probably had a much greater focus on community and the impacts on community, but of course this one I think gives me a greater financial understanding and the economics that have been used to develop our strategies.
My name is Scott Hamilton. I'm the member of the Legislative Assembly in British Columbia, Canada, for the constituency of Delta North. The last 3 days have been fairly intense. I've learned a lot. It's been a great exchange of ideas. I'm acutely aware now of many of the challenges that are being faced by several of the people from countries that are have emerging economies. The difficulties that they're experiencing. Hopefully, they're people like them and people like us are going to learn from everyone else's best practices. There was a lot to absorb. I'll be taking a lot home with me and look forward to. To maybe attending another event like this sometime in the future and touch base and see how well we progress with the information that we've taken home.
My name is Honorable Victor Mokolo, member representing ICA Federal Constituency of Delta State and the chairman Petroleum Upstream Committee of the House of Representatives of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, National Assembly. I feel excited being here. I feel excited interacting with my colleagues from Kenya, from Zambia, from Australia, from Canada, and many others. But I'm particularly grateful to the resource persons. To say that it's a program I recommend for not just chairman of the committee, for every member of the upstream committee. It's a program that I will recommend to my speaker.